I'm Frank Dorman from Penn State University, where I'm a professor in the Department of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. So at ASMS, at the Waters Users Group meeting, I was actually talking about some of the research that we've been doing on mixed halogenated dioxins and furans, which are compounds that are created as combustion byproducts in fires, both household fires and commercial office building type fires. The research that we're really doing, again, falls into the category of environmental exposure and environmental forensics, trying to figure out what molecules have entered the environment, how they've gotten there, and whether we should be concerned about them. And we're utilizing instrumentation like the Waters Zevo TQS to probe more sensitive and selective in terms of this rather complex chemical analysis. So I think that our work is showing a couple of things. One is that these molecules are clearly being formed and that people are clearly being exposed to them. And additionally, that exposure may be of concern because their receptor affinity seems to be equivalent to, in most cases, the polychlorinated analogs that have been studied and controlled for many years. It's only really very recently that we've been able to do this analysis using this piece of instrumentation. So very little is actually known about these molecules in the environment prior to some of the work that we've been doing. And I think it's very significant because, in particular, firefighters have various different cancer rates that are elevated above the normal population. And I'm not saying that these molecules are the reason, but they may be a contributor. And so there's very little understood about the environmental exposure these people have from, you know, occupational exposure that these people have, and then potentially environmental exposure of the general population, because once formed, they enter the environment and they basically stay there. So we use this instrument, specifically the Waters Zevo TQS, for a variety of different applications, including the analysis of chemotherapeutic drugs in wastewater and drinking water, as well as polybrominated diphenyl ethers in a variety of different types of samples. And in general, we're applying this technology to the analysis of a lot of halogenated POPs, or persistent environmental pollutants. Well, I think one of the big key updates in this work has been that we've completed really two studies of note. One is we've completed the receptor binding study to show that these molecules are every bit as concerning as their polychlorinated brothers. And the other is that we've proven that this instrument is capable of at least the level of performance of the traditional magnetic sector-based high-res instruments, and actually is about anywhere from a factor of 2 to 20 times more sensitive and has that much more improvement in method detection limits. Well, I think the future of this research in particular is going to be targeted towards developing more environmental regulatory methods towards analysis of a wider range of these types of molecules than has historically been done, especially within North America, but actually globally as well. A lot of these compounds that we're investigating with the Zevo TQS right now are actually unregulated throughout the globe, but clearly they do pose the potential for environmental impact. And so I think that maybe hopefully the most important outcome of this work will be adoption of additional methodologies throughout the globe for analysis of these molecules.